Power BI versus Tableau. But can you instead make Power BI and Tableau work together? I'm going to show you the exact steps you need, but also answer why it actually makes a lot of sense for teams and organizations to have Power BI and Tableau play along. Now, whether you agree or disagree with my opinion, I would love to hear your thoughts on this topic, so just leave me a comment down below. And if you're interested in self-service BI, Power BI or Tableau, make sure to subscribe and click the bell icon so you're notified whenever I go live to answer your BI questions. I'm going to show you how to connect Tableau to a Power BI model, an Excel Power Pivot model, and to analysis services. Now, these are all flavors of the same thing, but I'll show you the steps for each. If instead you're looking for a head-to-head comparison of Power BI versus Tableau across five key factors, click here to watch that video or down in the details. First, let's talk about why you would even care to connect Tableau and Power BI together. Now, people often think about Power BI versus Tableau as an either-or choice. Now, I don't believe that's true. Imagine an organization using Office 365, Azure, Power BI, Excel, a Microsoft shop, if you will. But could there be a need for some Power users within that organization to use Tableau? Why not? Tableau is an industry-leading tool with really unique sets of capabilities built specifically around that Power user, that heavy-duty analyst. If the company would benefit from those insights, then why not enable that scenario? So in this scenario, our model is a Power BI model. A big breakthrough with Power BI is the ability to establish the single source of truth by creating the model. And I talk more about this in my Power BI step-by-step tutorial. You can click here to access that or from the link down below. So instead of creating hundreds or thousands of somewhat disconnected reports, you create one model. And all of your reports are powered by that one model, that single source of truth. And from that single source, you can connect a visualization tool of your choice. It could be Power BI reports and dashboards, or you could use Excel to create your reports, or even use Tableau. I call it BYOV, or bring your own visualization. Now let's see how we can hook up Tableau with Power BI. So here we are in Tableau, and let's see how we can use Tableau to connect to a Power BI model in a Power BI desktop file, maybe in a Power BI.com publish model, or what about an analysis services, SSAS tabular, or an Excel Power Pivot model. So let's look into these. Let's go back to Tableau, and we're gonna click on this service section. I'm gonna click more, and right there, it somehow moved down to the bottom, but there's analysis services and Microsoft Power Pivot. I'm gonna start with the first one, and let's see how that works. So I'm gonna say analysis services, and in here, you can point to an Azure analysis server or a server path that provide the server address that you have. Right now, I'm just running the SSAS tabular server on this current machine. So I'm just gonna say localhost, and that's good enough. I'm gonna use Windows authentication and just sign in. And now it's gonna show me the database. And I think of these as models, as different models. So right now I have, AdventureWorks and Hello World Picnic. And if I click on AdventureWorks, typically for models deploying on a SSAS tablet, you only see one cube inside there. So model, I just select that, and that's it. I'm ready to go. You can see kind of the fields here, but as soon as you go to worksheet, now you have all your measures down here. Now this in case are all the DAX measures that have been defined in the model. So all of that heavy lifting has already been done in the model. It's all ready to go, and now you're ready to use. So we can go sales by territories, and of course you can kind of build it using the full functionality of Tableau. This is probably not a great example given in AdventureWorks data, but again, all of that functionality is just here for you. All of the tables are available, and you can slice and dice it and analyze it as you need using the full capabilities of Tableau connected to our tabular server. Now let's do the next step and connect to an Excel Power Pivot model. So I'm gonna go back, and let's go back to Tableau. And I'm gonna go click more again. Power Pivot is right there, but you can select it from this list. Power Pivot, and in this case, now notice that you can also point to a SharePoint URL if Power Pivot files are being hosted on SharePoint, but I'm just gonna point to my local file.
let's see how this works. Oh, there we go. And AdventureWorks Power Pivot. Sign in. Great, so now it's connected to that. And in here, we can connect to the model. And as before, we have all of the measures listed out. And now I can just go to my sheet. Let's do a new one. And notice, so now I'm connected to this one, which is to the Power Pivot file. And it has its own set of measures and dimensions or tables as they existed in that Power Pivot model. So again, all of that work that has been already done in the model, now it's at your disposal to visualize it however you want in Tableau. All of the measures, all of the DAX measures in there, all of the dimensions tables are all in there. Okay, let's go connect to this Power BI model. Now, this one requires a step. So what we're going to do first is I'm going to launch to open this in Power BI Desktop. All right, so the file is open now. Now, guys, I've said this before that all of these technologies, SSAS Tabular, Excel Power Pivot, Power BI.com, Power BI Desktop, are essentially the same technology or pretty similar. So in fact, the Power BI Desktop is in a way running a Tabular server and an analysis server on your machine. We just have to find the port that we need to connect to. So this is not that different from, again, the server running and hosting this model. And so this technique is used quite commonly to also connect Excel to a running Power BI Desktop model. And the quickest way, or one of the ways at least, is you use the tool called DAX Studio. There are other ways to do it too, but I'm just going to show you this one. And you say connect. And this one lets you pick the Power BI model that's running. I'm going to connect to the AdventureWorks model that I just opened. Hit connect. And all I'm looking for here is really this information, that which port is it running on. So it's running on 57550. Now I have that information. I can just go back and say connect to analysis services and point to that port number. So I have the port number 57550. I'm going to click sign in and click on model, and voila, I'm connected to that. Let's create a new sheet, and this time, this one is connected to a Power BI Desktop model, but again, we have all the richness from that model, all the measures. You can see there's quarter date, year to date, prior year. You don't have to redefine any of that. That heavy lifting has already been done in the model, and you can simply reuse that and use Tableau as a visualization engine. Let's talk about the big one, the PowerBI.com datasets. How do we connect Tableau to these, right? That's the big question. Well, unfortunately, you can't. And it's not that you cannot connect any tool to these models. In fact, both Excel and Power BI have this capability. In Excel, using the Power BI add-in here, you can say connect to data, and this connects right to your Power BI datasets, and you can choose them there, and this will give you essentially a pivot table connected to that model in the cloud, PowerBI.com published model. And similarly, Power BI Desktop, you can also say get data, connect to Power BI dataset, and in here, again, it's connected to the cloud Power BI service. I can go to my workspace, connect to AdventureWorks, click load, which doesn't actually load. It's simply connecting to the data in the cloud, and I have I can build a report which is connected to that single source of truth. So other tools can connect to Power BI.com published model, but not Tableau, at least not right now.
But I have submitted requests to both Power BI and Tableau to make this possible. Find the link in the details below, and please, please vote for them and drop me a comment and let me know, because it would be a win-win-win. It would be a win for customers or consumers who are using these tools, because the reality is that modern organizations have a mix of tools, have a mix of software and service providers, and it really benefits us when they work together. But it's also a win for Microsoft and a win for Tableau or other third-party visualization tools, and here's why. In today's age, collaboration comes before competition. And nothing exemplifies that better than Microsoft under the helm of Satya Nadella. So my friend, let's make this possible. Go ahead and vote using the links below and just drop me a comment after you've done so. If you do have other thoughts around this topic, I would love to hear from you. Now, if you want to hear more from me and catch me live when I go live on YouTube, make sure to subscribe and click the bell. Until next time, power on, my friend.